So who is Venezuela's leader? Is it Nicolás Maduro, the man who's ruled since the death of Hugo Chavez 6 years ago? Or is it the opposition leader, Juan Guaidó, who declared himself caretaker president and swore to end what he calls a dictatorship? The United States and Canada were quick to back Mr. Guaidó, along with Brazil, Argentina, and Colombia. It all comes as Venezuela's long political and economic crisis grinds on. The economy is in freefall. In recent years, millions of Venezuelans have given up hope and left the country. With huge crowds on the streets of Caracas, this all feels like the most serious threat Mr. Maduro has ever faced. Of course, he has been through some of this before. There were months of street protests in 2014 and again in 2017. Each time the authorities cracked down, thousands were arrested and scores killed. But the pressures which drove people onto the streets before have all got worse. The shortages, the hyperinflation, the sense that Venezuela is falling apart. The other difference is the international reaction. America has warned the authorities that all options are on the table if they resort to violence. Canada says the Maduro government is now a dictatorship, and the EU is calling for the start of a political process that leads to free and credible elections. Russia has accused the West of gross interference, and of course, a long history of US involvement in Latin America may mean that Washington has to tread carefully. Will Mr. Maduro simply tough it out again as he has before? All eyes are on the military. If they remain loyal, then another bloody crackdown is likely. If they follow Juan Guaidó, then Mr. Maduro's days are numbered. And if they're divided, Venezuela's crisis could get a whole lot worse.